Hello and welcome to the big picture. Now that the formation of a separate state of Telangana has become a reality, despite the expected resistance we are witnessing in non-Telangana regions in the last 24 hours, several birth pangs can be expected on the way. One of the biggest challenges for those who sit to divide the state will be the capital city of Hyderabad. The Congress Working Committee resolution recommending that it be a joint capital for 10 years before the state of Simandra or whatever it would be called develops its own capital has evoked mixed response from both sides. While the Telanganites think that 10 years is too long a time for developing a new capital for Simandra, people from latter areas who have substantial interests in Hyderabad are not happy about the formula. The Telanganites' fear or concern stemmed from the experience of Chandigarh, which has been a joint capital of Haryana and Punjab for the last 47 years. On the other hand, the huge interests, financial and otherwise, of people from non-Telangana region in Hyderabad, called settlers in local parlance, is naturally causing concern about their future. We will today look at the proposal of Hyderabad as a joint capital and look at all the pros and cons of the viability and acceptability of the proposal. To discuss this, I have with me P.P. Rao, a distinguished senior advocate of the Supreme Court, who incidentally hails from Simandra. V.K. Agnihotri, former Secretary General of Raj Sabha, who has served in Andhra Pradesh, his home cadre as an IAS officer. Ponnam Prabhakar will be joining us very soon. Parsa Venkateshwar Rao, Jr., editorial consultant at the DNA newspaper and a staunch Hyderabadi, though he has lived in Delhi for over two decades. And on the phone line from Hyderabad is Vinod Kumar, a former MP belonging to the Telangana Rashtra Samiti. Welcome to all of you. I would like to go to Mr. Vinod Kumar first. Mr. Vinod Kumar, you there?
Yes, yes, please.
Okay, Mr. Vinod Kumar, now that this long struggle for a separate state has almost come to fruition, now what is it that you people have a problem with this formula which has been the resolution of the Congress Working Committee?
Sir, good evening to you and all.
Yes.
You see, the Telangana struggle for a separate statehood is a long struggle right from the day one of Andhra Pradesh formation on 1st November 1956.
Yes.
From the day one, the people of Telangana were fighting for a separate statehood, and in the year 1969, there was a very big struggle. Around 350 students and youth were killed in the police firing. And ultimately, the movement took a democratic movement in the way of a political party, that is the Telangana Rashtra Samiti,
yes,
on whose behalf I was elected in the year 2004 to 2009,
yes,
on behalf of the TRS party. So, after we being a part of UPA government in 2004, in the common minimum program, the issue of Telangana.
This is all history which most of us know. But with this, with the present proposal, do you have any problem with the present proposal?
No, what I would like to tell you is that 10 years is too long. 10 years is not necessary for constructing of a new capital. Simandra does have few cities like Vijayawada, Guntur, Visakhapatnam, Tirupati, Karnool.
Yes.
They are already a big municipal corporation.
Right.
So in the event they want to develop a new capital, what is needed is only a secretariat, a legislative assembly, chief minister residence, governor residence, some quarters for the MLAs and the staff. I hope that this can be constructed in the new technology within 2 or 3 years.
Okay.
So it would be fine if they keep for 2 or 3 years, but 10 years is too long. But however, we doesn't want to make it as an issue.
Okay.
And yesterday, my leader, K. Chandrasekhar Rao, has categorically stated that we are not against for a government to be run from Hyderabad or Simandra. There is a lot of difference between Chandigarh and Hyderabad.
Absolutely.
Chandigarh,
we will come to that. Vinod Kumar, I'll come to you. We'll come to that Chandigarh comparison a little later. Please stay on. Mr. Rao, this 10 years, giving this time 10 years for this for Hyderabad to become a joint capital, what do you think of it? Especially in the context of that, no, there is no geographical contiguity as far as the Simandra, the rest of Andhra is concerned, and Telangana,
yes,
when it comes to Hyderabad.
Yes. You see, so far as the the period of 10 years is concerned, it is perhaps based on their assessment of the situation and also the feelings on both sides,
yes,
which have taken an emotional turn, and also a kind of a pragmatic view according to them, if they seem to have taken it. I think this is a historic moment when it is not the duration of joint capital that should be an issue, serious issue. Main issue is about the division of the state itself.
Yes.
And it is obvious that...
And what are your views on the division of state?
People of Telangana, by and large, appear to be happy because their kind of emotional movement has been built up,
yes,
assiduously, particularly of 2009. And naturally, they are quite happy about it. But what I am really seriously concerned about it is, in which direction the country is going. Why divisive appeals are having more receptivity as compared to politics of unity? And if one state is formed, look at immediately, there are cries.
Last 24 hours, the demands have...
Demands again, yes. Vidarbha state, Gorkhaland, and things like that. So therefore, in which direction we are going, number one?
No, but, please finish.
Secondly, what I don't appreciate is, why this movement did not ask for restoration of old Hyderabad state, including those areas which have gone to Karnataka and Maharashtra. Why they did not ask for it? It should have been a very logical demand. I am not able to understand why it is.
You are trying to go back to the pre-1947 situation.
Naturally, that was united. Hyderabad state ruled by the Nizam. So if you want to revive the old thing.
So yeah, but you think that this division of the state is something which could have been avoided? Is that what you're trying to say?
It could have been avoided, according to me, if when Rajshekhar Reddy unfortunately passed away suddenly, if they had sent Mr. Jaipal Reddy as Chief Minister of the state, he was from Telangana, a very elderly statesman, probably the movement would have picked up through this emotional pitch. That's my feeling.
Okay. Mr. Agnihotri, this whole, first the separation, the division of the state, and then about capital city of Hyderabad being a joint capital.
No, first thing is, it is, as the papers have said, are saying that at the age of 66, the mother India is going to deliver a child. It is not a delivery of a child. It is actually a divorce in a marriage which has gone sour. So this marriage took place in 1956.
Six.
And within 13 years, that is 69, the signs were that the marriage is not working.
Yes.
So after 44 years of proceedings at different levels, now it is proposed that the divorce should be approved. So that is the situation how it is. And therefore it is very unique that, against the recommendations of the state reorganization commission,
yes,
this state was created in the first instance.
Right.
And against the, even at that time, the prime minister also felt that there is no need to join the two together. So somehow it has not worked out, so they are going back to where it is, and that is where our Mr. Rao is also mentioning. If you are dividing, if you are separating, then let us go back to as it was.
Parsa? Would you like to have that old Hyderabad state?
Yeah, I would personally like to have...
What Mr.
Yeah, I really plead for the old Hyderabad state for two reasons. One, it will become a multilingual state because the districts that went to Karnataka and went to Maharashtra were Marathi speaking and Kannada speaking, and the districts that remained are Telugu speaking. You know, Hyderabad state under the Nizam was a multilingual state,
right,
multicultural state. So as a matter of fact, one of the recommendations of the early commissions was Fazal Ali Commission and other people is retain Hyderabad as an ideal state which reflects the diversity of the country as such. But there is a political issue there. You know, the Telugu...
When it was decided to divide states on linguistic basis,
yes,
this is what
that became. No. The reason is the Telugu-speaking people of Telangana were not too happy jostling with the Kannada-speaking districts and the Marathi-speaking districts. They wanted to have something on their own. And that is the reason they were tempted to join the Vishalandra, the other districts, thinking that perhaps it would work out. Actually, the old Hyderabad state is a very ideal one. And secondly, the Hyderabad state existed from 48 to 56.
Right.
And the Andhra state existed from 53 to 56.
Right.
So they existed separately and they could have. Now what is happening is they are going back to their original forms. at what they were in 56.
But as far as Hyderabad is concerned, now that I don't think we can go back on this, and there won't be any major change to the Congress Working Committee proposal resolution of, you know, what has been said now. They say that it's going to be two different states with Hyderabad as the joint capital. Tell me, what are the problems of Hyderabad being a joint capital for, say, for 10 years, if it has to be for 10 years?
Very simple reason. You know, the 10-year period can be worked out. Either you can make it 5 or 10 or 7, whatever it is. But basically, Hyderabad remains the part of the Telangana region geographically. And the Andhra would people would need a 200-mile corridor to come to Hyderabad.
That is exactly the point. You know, this 200-mile corridor from any part of the
So what they need is they may have to work
hasten hasten this thing.
No, then let them take their time.
Mr. Rao, you think that Mr. Agnihotri, you think that this has, whether even though 10 years time limit has been given, it will be in the interest of Simandra people or whatever that state is going to be called to develop their own capital as soon as possible, because this traveling 200 kilometers to reach their capital is going to be a very impractical thing.
No, it is not only a question of traveling 200 kilometers. Where is the place, or where will the assembly function? Where will the secretary function? In Hyderabad.
Yes.
Other one. They will have to build. And if they have to build, then why not you build somewhere else?
Yes, sir. Another dimension to the whole thing. It is not a question of construction of a few buildings.
Yes.
People who had gone there thinking this is our state and they invested colossal amounts
that
in
is
Hyderabad.
That is exactly
for the them point. To pull out from there, re-establish the Andhra region. It is not an overnight job.
But Mr. Rao, my question is, why should they pull out from there?
For this reason, once this kind of an emotional feeling has come up that you belong to a different place, you don't belong to this place. Once that feeling has come, it becomes emotionally difficult for them to continue to invest what they have been doing earlier, or to allow the investments to still grow further. So therefore, for
It is said that 16 families, and how far it is authenticated, but there has been reports saying that 16 families from Andhra region, from the Simandra region, have control over something like 1 lakh acres of land in Hyderabad itself. Is this one of the major reasons why there has been this resistance?
No, not only this. So many families.
And also the industries, the cap. Majority of the, about 70% of what the investments in Hyderabad has been done by people from outside the Telangana region.
Yes. There is no doubt about it. It's an objective fact that Telangana development has seen unprecedented heights after the formation of Andhra Pradesh. And largely, but more investment has come from Andhra region than from Telangana region, for obvious reasons, because Telangana was a backward area. But then the point is, not only the investors who have gone there, a handful of them or 16 of them, whatever it is, so many families moved to the capital city from Andhra.
Right.
They are all part of Andhra state government. All employees have come over here. Public sector employees, all of them come over here. It was a huge exodus which has come.
Right.
They have settled down from 1956 till now. How many years have gone
many
by?
Many of them are second generation, third generation.
Third generation. Now, earlier we had a Mulki rule.
Yes.
Anyone who was a permanent resident for 15 years was a Mulki.
Yes.
Entitled to all rights. Now, they are all Mulkis if you go by the definition.
Yes.
What do you do with them?
Mr. Vinod Kumar, this is a question which has been raised often. What is it that, you people who have spearheaded this movement for a separate state, what kind of assurances are you going to give to the people who have come and settled down there as their own capital, and now they must feel a sense of alienation?
You see, the movement for the last 12 years has already given an assurance to the people of Simandra. Not even a single incident of any assault on any Andhra entrepreneur has taken place in Hyderabad or in any city of Telangana. So this movement was a peaceful movement in a democratic movement, and we have built this movement to giving assurance to the people of Simandra. Even when there was Sakala Janala Samay for 40 days, all the employees of Telangana and the advocates, doctors, everybody participated in a long-term struggle, but no incident occurred in Hyderabad. particularly against Andhra people. So this is as if we were giving them right from the day one when we started the movement. We never said Andhra go back as it was done in the 1969. So that was the assurance given by this movement to the people of Simandhra.
Mr. Vinod Kumar, I think I need to contest that claim of yours, because one of the slogans of TRS when it started was that Telangana walo jago, Andhra wale bago. You know, this was one of the slogans which has created this kind of disquiet in the minds of people who are non-Telanganites settled in Hyderabad and other parts of Telangana. Don't you agree with that, that this was a slogan which was used by the TRS?
No, this was given, this is the case, that where the assign lines were used up by a person from Simandhra region. The assigned lands which were given to the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes were purchased, which is an illegal. Who were purchased? Even a Telangana instituted purchase, which is. Then he said that it is not correct. And when he was a person from the other region who is politically more powerful with the then Chief Minister, Mr. Rajshekhar Reddy, and his family, then we gave the slogan. It was not a general slogan against the Andhra people. That was a movement in Medak district. Particularly, it went on only for 15 days, where the government had constituted a committee and could find that the assigned lands were purchased by such person, and the government had ordered the revenue division officer to take it over.
Okay, we please clear, and I'll come back to you. Parsa, you think that explanation that what he is giving, that the assurances they have given.
I think what will happen is the people...
No, because the fact of the matter, Parsa, is that there is a lot of disquiet among the people of non-Telangana region who are in Hyderabad. We have read reports, we have heard from people that there is a clear divide between the two. There has been, I've read stories and I've heard stories from people saying that people who used to go on their morning walks together, now they go on separate, the Telangana people go on a walk separately, and this kind of, there's a divide.
Yeah, no, let me tell you how it will work out is, like, if I'm staying in Delhi, I'm not a Delhiite, but I'm not threatened. So people from Andhra who have settled, not just the rich 16 families or 20 families, but the ordinary people who came to study, who came to work, who have settled down for the last 50 years, especially in the government services, I think they will continue like they stay in any cosmopolitan city of India. In Bangalore, there are many Tamilians, many Andhras, many Mumbaikers, so it doesn't create a problem. What will create a problem is for the Andhra person in Hyderabad, who wielded a political clout because his government was there, that will diminish.
His government means what?
No, because the Andhra ministers were there.
Yes.
And they were in a majority.
And chief ministers, majority of
them
came from there.
Had a certain confidence and think that, yes, we can do things. Now, what will happen is that political clout will diminish because there will be a Telangana minister and a Telangana chief minister. But you know, the same lobbying which went with the Andhra minister or Andhra chief minister will continue along for the Telangana government also. The same lobbying, the same money pressures. So I don't see that changing. And the economic loss will take place. If people who have got investment want to stay in Hyderabad, I think they will continue to stay and prosper. But what really intrigues me is the Telugu film industry. Okay? Whether the Telugu film industry will continue to be in Hyderabad or not,
yes.
I think they may continue, because Telugu films are most ardently, passionately seen in Telangana as much as they are seen in Rayalaseema and the coastal Andhra places. So I don't think the film industry, though the film industry is dominated only by the Andhras.
Completely dominated by the Andhras.
So that will be an intriguing question.
Mr. Agnihotri? You know,
what I would like to say is that there is one article 371D.
Yes.
Which provides for special dispensation in services, other things for the Telangana, because that was part of the thing
that's
that emerged.
Six-point formula in the 71.
Emerged from the agitation. I mean, some pacification or something was done. Now that article will have to be replaced with some other article to provide for certain arrangements apart from continuing Hyderabad as a state in respect of
Hyderabad
as a
capital.
Apart from that, for people, because these people are not only in Hyderabad, I have heard in Nizamabad, there are areas in Nizamabad where a lot of settlers, as you mentioned.
Yes.
So there will have to be some dispensation for them so that they are not just thrown out and get their rights there.
Mr. Rao, there are a lot of these kind of problems which will crop up now in the process of dividing the state and dividing the all the assets and liabilities and things like that. So what Mr. Agnewal is suggesting about 371D,
that requires amendment. 370 protected, protect the concept of local candidates.
Right.
And enable the president to make reservation for them in jobs. So those have been
made. But it didn't work.
But whether it worked or not, it gave some kind of a satisfaction, assurance to the people. But my problem is, by these mechanisms, where are we heading? Where is the country going? One thing is clear. Earlier it was thought language is a bond. Now it is demonstrated it is not. See what happened in UP.
Yes.
What happened in Bihar. Language did not hold them together. Separation was
there. Madhya Pradesh.
And what's happening in Maharashtra.
Right.
Vidarbha wants to separate. Therefore, language ceased to be a bond.
Exactly. Language has ceased to be an issue now.
Then another...
Sir, yes. 2000, when all these three states were formed, the new states were formed, it was not on the basis. The linguistic basis for creation of states is no more valid. Now, from Telangana's experience, we can see that economic issues, the issue of development seems to be the basis for creation of new states.
I am also concerned about the problems of sharing of river waters.
Yes.
Assets and liabilities and various other things. And then we have not solved the dispute on Kaveri waters between Tamil Nadu and Karnataka.
And Haryana and Punjab.
Now, right now, Supreme Court is seized of bench of five judges or seized of Mulla Periyar Dam issue between Kerala and Tamil Nadu. So, and Maharashtra and Andhra, they have got that Babli project, etc.
Yes.
They had their own problems. And Supreme Court is flooded with these suits.
Right.
Filed by states. Because politicians are not able to solve the problem themselves. They can create, but they are unable to solve. So they take refuge in the Supreme Court. Now, where are we heading? Are we splitting, and increasing the problems?
So you are obviously not a protagonist of a smaller state or dividing the state. Mr. Vinod Kumar, see, there is one more issue which came up during the last few weeks during the discussions. Even Sri Krishna Commission report had mentioned it, about forming some kind of a Royal Telangana. Is that a dead issue now? Or do you think that during the course of the group of ministers looking into this, once the group of ministers have formed, this proposal could be revived?
No, I don't think so. Yesterday, the Congress Working Committee has categorically stated the formation of Telangana statehood with only 10 districts of Telangana. So the issue of Royal Telangana, that is two districts, that is the Karnool and Anantapur should be annexed to Telangana, is not correct. Because Rayalaseema has four districts as on today, that is Anantapur, Chittoor, Kadapa and Karnool.
Right.
They have a cultural identity and a long history of regionalism.
Right.
So we are not asking for division of Rayalaseema region into two, one with Telangana, the other with Andhra. What I would like to tell is, Rayalaseema and the coastal districts were a state. They got separated from the Madras state in the year 1953.
Right.
And they survived till 1956.
Right.
That was a state. And in fact, all those regions, that is Andhra, coastal Andhra and Rayalaseema, they fought against the Madras, in Madras state for a separate statehood.
Right.
On the issue of Telugu language.
Absolutely.
So it was a state and Telangana region which was a part and parcel of the then Hyderabad state. It was a residual state.
Right.
See, Marathi speaking people, they went to Maharashtra and the Kannada speaking went to Karnataka, that is then Mysore state.
Right.
And only Telugu speaking people in Hyderabad state, that was a residual state of Hyderabad, they were merged with Andhra state. Now what we are asking is only demerger of Telangana region from Andhra Pradesh.
So
we are not interested to have those two districts because unnecessary it will crop up some other problems in the future and let Telangana as a state would survive on its own because it was a long pending issue and
but
it was the desire of the Telangana region people but for a separate statehood.
Mr. Vinod Kumar, quickly, but do you assure the people of non-Telangana regions who have settled down in Hyderabad now for the last so many years, that in the next few years that it will take for a new capital to be formed by the other state, that you know they will not be disturbed, they will not feel insecure in the place in Hyderabad?
Definitely, sir. In fact, there won't be any problem. No settler in Hyderabad. People who came from other region for the last 50 years who have settled in Hyderabad, they are not raising this issue.
Okay.
They know we'll that see. They doesn't have any problem in Hyderabad.
We will see. Yes, Parsa. This assurance, one. Second thing is, you know, what I find very curious is that they're still called settlers. You know, they have not been the problem of this.
Is not with the Andhras who are settled in Hyderabad.
Yes.
The problem is with the political power structure.
Okay.
Now, with the formation of Telangana, the Telangana people who feel that they were not, who didn't get their due in the political structure, they will come into power, because the ordinary people, whether they are from Andhra or Telangana, I think they mix with each other quite well.
So now,
and Hyderabad will always remain a cosmopolitan place. Even before the merger of Andhra Pradesh, we had a lot of people from Maharashtra, the Kannada-speaking people, Tamil-speaking people, Gujaratis, Marwadis. So it's Hyderabad has always been a cosmopolitan place. As a matter of fact, after the merging, after the Andhra Pradesh, it became the capital of Andhra Pradesh, that cosmopolitanism got diluted a bit. Now it will go back to the cosmopolitan thing.
You think it will go back to the cosmopolitan thing? Mr. Pipilo, last words to you. Do you think that this assurance is being given that Hyderabad will be a safe place for both, you know, everybody, and whenever it has to be transferred, whenever the new state is formed, people will have to go there? You think that is a reassuring
thing? It's a welcome assurance. It is that they will have nothing to worry about so long as they are there, and they are treated as part of any other part citizen of Telangana. That's a very welcome assurance indeed. But one question still to be addressed by everyone is, what about the common man? Is he going to have better governance in Telangana region, in Telangana state? Or it is even repeating what was going on earlier?
I think on that note, I think we are completely run out of time. We have to end. That is a question which I am sure will be on the minds of everybody when the new state is formed, whether the formation of the new state will mean better life and better standards of living for the people of the new state. We'll have to wait and watch what will happen. Thanks to all my guests, Mr. Vinod Kumar, Mr. P.P. Rao, Mr. Agnihotri, and Parsa Venkateshwar Rao. Please keep watching. We'll come back with another issue in Big Picture, same time tomorrow.